Let's bring in Julia Manchester, national reporter, a political reporter for The Hill. This round of primaries could really predict in real time whether Republicans have enough power to flip enough seats to take control of the House, right?
Absolutely. I think you will see a lot of Republicans really eyeing some of these major House districts or the primaries in these districts. So you have, for example, in North Carolina, Madison Cawthorn's district, but also in Oregon, for example, across the country, you have Democrats like Kurt Schrader, incumbents and moderate Democrats who are going up against progressive primary challenges. And we know that House Republicans have very much targeted some of those seats, including Schrader's seat. So yes, absolutely. We have some predictions that Republicans and Democrats could be making after primary night tonight. But also, like Kelly mentioned in her piece just before this, we do know that going into some of these Senate races and gubernatorial races, this is a major test for President Trump's endorsement. And I'll note that it's not just Oz's, Dr. Oz's Senate primary or the Republican primary in Pennsylvania, for example. Out in Idaho, you have Governor Brad Little, who is facing a primary challenge from his own lieutenant governor, who has been endorsed by Donald Trump. So a big test for the Trump brand today and tonight.
Well, you mentioned Dr. Oz in Pennsylvania. The race is tightening there for the GOP seat or nomination, rather. Another controversial personality. If he wins, could this be another sign, like in Ohio, where we saw J.D. Vance take the nomination, that American voters are just fed up over classic politics and career politicians?
It could be a sign, absolutely. But if Kathy Barnett wins at the same time, I would say that's another sign that Americans are fed up over these classic career politicians. You know, look, I think we've seen at this point with some of the recent, you know, candidates we've seen on the Republican side and also to an extent on the Democratic side, you have had these figures who have no background in politics really starting to emerge in American politics. This is the new blood that we're seeing coming into races really across the country. So I absolutely think that's a sign of it. At the same time, though, I think what most people are watching, what most political experts are really watching here is that Trump endorsement. Can it hold? Can it hold in Pennsylvania, North Carolina, and Oregon, or Idaho, I should say? We'll have to see.
Well, you mentioned Trump endorsements. In North Carolina, you got a couple of young bucks that Trump has backed in two different districts. Of course, controversial again, Madison Cawthorn, and he's saying he deserves a second chance. Then you have this other 26-year-old, they both happen to be 26, Beau Hines, running for the first time. Talk about them.
Yeah, absolutely. These are both young Republicans running in North Carolina, very similar because of their age. But we've seen Madison Cawthorn get quite a bit of attention lately because he's giving the GOP establishment on Capitol Hill a huge headache. I mean, Republicans don't want to be talking about cocaine-fueled orgies at this point or whatever Madison Cawthorn is talking about. We know that there were some pictures that emerged of him in women's lingerie, for example, that caused quite a bit of stir in Washington. They want to be talking about inflation, crime, and the border. So we saw that with Madison Cawthorn, for example, he sort of diverted from that message with his own personal news or personal developments that we saw play out in the media. And we do know that Kevin McCarthy, for example, who very much wants to be House Majority Leader, does not want to be talking about that. So you have that dynamic playing out on Capitol Hill, Adrian, but then you have someone like President Trump, the de facto leader of the Republican Party, throwing his support behind Cawthorn. So we'll have to see which of those forces ultimately are able to prevail going into primary night. I will say that, you know, a sitting senator from North Carolina has endorsed Cawthorn's primary challenger. So Cawthorn's got an uphill climb ahead as an incumbent.
Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.